नमस्कार दोस्तों, तो कैसे हैं आप लोग? आशा करता हूँ आप लोग बहुत ही अच्छे होंगे और हेल्दी एंड फिट होंगे। आज हम लोग करने आ रहे हैं चैप्टर नंबर 7 पॉलिटिकल साइंस NCERT क्लास 8th की रीडिंग दोस्तों। और मैं आपको पहले ही बता दूं कि मैं दो चीज़ें नहीं करता, आपको समझाता नहीं हूँ और ना ही ये चैप्टर की समरी लिखवाता हूँ। मैं केवल आपके लिए इस चैप्टर की रीडिंग करके देता हूँ ताकि आपका जो कीमती समय है वो बच जाए और आपकी रीडिंग भी हो जाए और आपको रीडिंग करनी भी ना पड़े। इस फॉर्मूला पर मैं चलता हूँ दोस्तों। आप अगर मेरे किए हुए रीडिंग को 5 से 6 बार सुन लेंगे तो आपके दिमाग में NCERT छपना शुरू हो जाएगा। ये बात एकदम बहुत ही ज़्यादा लाजमी है कि ऐसा होना ही है, बिल्कुल ठीक है। मैक्सिमम लोगों के केस में ऐसा ज़रूर होगा दोस्तों। और NCERT एक बार आपके दिमाग में छप जाए तो आपको क्वेश्चन आंसर याद करने में बिल्कुल भी कोई दिक्कत नहीं आएगी और आप एकदम मस्ती से पढ़ पाएंगे। और आपको NCERT बुक जो आपको बोरिंग लगती है, कुछ बच्चों को, मैक्सिमम बच्चों को जो बोरिंग लगती है वो बोरिंग नहीं लगेगी, ठीक है। चलिए दोस्तों तो शुरू करते हैं चैप्टर नंबर 7 अंडरस्टैंडिंग मार्जिनलाइजेशन। व्हाट डज इट मीन टू बी सोशली मार्जिनलाइज्ड? टू बी मार्जिनलाइज्ड इज टू बी फोर्स्ड टू ऑक्यूपाई द साइड्स और फिंगर्स एंड डज नॉट बी एट द सेंटर ऑफ थिंग्स। दिस इज समथिंग दैट सम ऑफ यू हैव प्रोबेबली एक्सपीरियंस्ड इन द क्लासरूम और प्लेग्राउंड। इफ यू आर नॉट लाइक्ड मोस्ट पीपल इन योर क्लास, if you are not like most people in your class, that is if your taste in music or films is different, if your accent marks you out from others, if you are less chatty than others in your class, if you don't play the same sport that many of your classmates like, if you dress differently, the changes are that you will not be considered to be in by your peers. So often you end up feeling that you are not with it, as if what you say, feel and think, how act are not quite right or acceptable to others. As in the classroom, in the social environment too, groups of people or communities may have the experience of being excluded. Their marginalization can be because they speak a different language, follow different customs or belong to a different religious group from the majority community. They may also feel marginalized because they are poor, considered to be one of low social status and viewed as being less human than others. Sometimes marginalized groups are viewed with hostility and fear. This sense of difference and exclusion leads to communities not having access to resources and opportunities, and in their inability to assert their rights. They experience a sense of disadvantage and powerlessness vis-a-vis more powerful and dominant sections of society who own land, are wealthy, better educated and politically powerful. Thus, marginalization is seldom experienced in one sphere. Economic, social, cultural and political factors work together to make certain groups in society feel marginalized. In this chapter, you will read about two communities that are considered to be socially marginalized in India today. Adivasis and marginalization. An Adivasi family in Delhi, Soma and Helen, are watching the Republic Day parade on TV with their grandfather. Oh, see, an Adivasi float. Dadu, why do they always show Adivasis as only dancing? When I was young, our village in Odisha was beautiful. We got everything we needed from the land and the forests around us. We in turn respected the land, the forest, the river. Then how did you survive, Dadu? Many of us were forced to leave our village, leave our homes and final seasonal work in nearby towns. Yes, don't they know us anything? Don't they know anything else about us? The lives of Adivasis are very rich. Most people don't know that. Suddenly, we were told that the forest was not ours. Forest officials and contractors cut down large parts of it. If we protested, they beat us and then took us to court, where we did not have our lawyers and could not fight our cases. Then the company wallahs came. They said there was iron ore under our land. They wanted to mine it. They promised jobs and money if we sold our land to them. Some villagers were excited. Others said this would destroy our lives and we would get nothing. We would get nothing. Some gave thumbprints, not realizing they were selling their lands off. Only a few were given token jobs, but most of us did not sell. Acquire tribal lands का एक file है दोस्तों, इसके आस में देख सकते हैं आप लोग दोस्तों. Then they beat and threatened us till eventually everyone was forced to sell and abandoned the lands of their forefathers. They had the support of the authorities. Our whole way of living vanished overnight. The money hardly lasted in the city. We had no means of livelihood anymore. We were all cramped into a tiny rented home. How we missed our carefree lives, the open spaces. I hated going back to school. We had missed so much of our studies and other children made fun of us. We spoke Santhali at home and did not know Hindi. But now we have friends. I can even speak some English now. Oh Dadu, and our land what? For our 30 acres, we got a little money from one contractor. I never saw most of my friends again. After a few years, your father got a job in Delhi and we all moved here. Those were very difficult times. That is why both of you did not go to school for several years. I wish I could have shown my friends our village before it was destroyed. You can still tell them about our village. It has a lot to teach them. One day I will make movie on this story. Our story, the Adivasi story. You just read about how Dadu was forced to leave his village in Odisha. Dadu's story is similar to the lives of millions of Adivasis in India. You will read more about the marginalization of this community in this chapter. यहाँ पे दोस्तों कुछ क्वेश्चन दे रखे हैं, इसको अपने टीचर के साथ आप डिस्कस करके जरूर इसका आंसर फाइंड करने की कोशिश करें जो जेन्युइन क्वेश्चन है, ठीक है? कुछ फालतू वाले होते हैं उसका आंसर नहीं फाइंड करना. Who are Adivasis? Adivasis, the term literally means original inhabitants, are communities who lived and often continue to live in close association with forests. Around 8% of India's population is Adivasi, and many of India's most important mining and industrial centers are located in Adivasi areas, Jamshedpur, Raurkela, Bokaro, Bhilai, among others. Adivasis are not a homogeneous population. There are over 500 different Adivasi groups in India. Adivasis are particularly numerous in states like Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Rajasthan, Andhra Pradesh, West Bengal, and in northeastern states of Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Nagaland, and Tripura. A state like Odisha is home to more than 60 different tribal groups. Adivasi societies are also most distinctive because there is often very little hierarchy among them. This makes them radically different from communities organized around principles of Jati, Varna, caste, or those that were ruled by kings. Tribals are also referred to as Adivasis. You may have heard the term scheduled tribes. Scheduled tribes is the term used for Adivasi, used by the Indian government in various official documents. There is an official list of tribes. Scheduled tribes are often grouped together with scheduled castes in the category scheduled castes and scheduled tribes. Adivasis practice a range of tribal religions that are different from Islam, Hinduism, and Christianity. These often involve the worship of ancestors, village, and nature spirits. The land associated with and residing in various sites in the landscape, mountain spirits, river spirits, animal spirits, etc. The village spirits are often worshipped at specific sacred grooves within the village boundary, while the ancestral ones are usually worshipped at home. Additionally, Adivasis have been influenced by different surrounding religions like Shakta, Buddhist, Vaishnava, Bhakti, and Christianity. Simultaneously, Adivasis आदिवासी रिलीजन्स themselves हैव इन्फ्लुएंस्ड डोमिनेंट रिलीजन्स ऑफ द एम्पायर्स अराउंड देम। ये सब दोस्तों कुछ क्वेश्चन है, इसको अपने टीचर के साथ मिलके सॉल्व करने की कोशिश करें अगर जेन्युइन है तो। आदिवासी रिलीजन्स themselves हैव इन्फ्लुएंस्ड डोमिनेंट रिलीजन्स ऑफ एम्पायर्स ऑफ द एम्पायर्स अराउंड देम। फॉर एग्जाम्पल एट जगन्नाथ कल्ट ऑफ उड़ीसा एंड शक्ति एंड तांत्रिक ट्रेडिशंस इन बंगाल एंड असम ड्यूरिंग द 19th सेंचुरी सब्सटैंशियल मेंबर्स ऑफ आदिवासीज कन्वर्टेड टू क्रिश्चियनिटी विच हैज़ इमर्ज्ड एज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिलीजन इन मॉडर्न आदिवासी हिस्ट्री। आदिवासीज हैव देयर ओन लैंग्वेजेस मोस्ट ऑफ देम रेडिकली डिफरेंट फ्रॉम एंड पॉसिबली एज ओल्ड एज संस्कृत which have often deeply influenced the formation of mainstream Indian languages like Bengali. Santhali has the largest number of speakers and has a significant body of publications including magazines on the internet or in e-zines. The above two images of tribal communities in their traditional customs are often the only ways in which Adivasi communities are represented. This then leads us to think of them as being exotic and backward. ये दिखा रखा है दोस्तों आदिवासीज एंड स्टीरियोटाइपिंग। In India we usually showcase Adivasi communities in particular ways. Thus, during school functions or other official events or in books and movies, Adivasis are invariably portrayed in very stereotypical ways, in colorful costumes, headgear and through their dancing. Besides this, we seem to know very little about the realities of their lives. This often wrongly leads to people believing that they are exotic, primitive and backward. Often Adivasis are blamed for their lack of advancement as they are believed to be resistant to change or new ideas. You will remember that you read in class 6 book how stereotyping particular communities can lead to people discriminating against such groups. Adivasis and development. As you have already read in your history textbook, forests were absolutely crucial to the development of all empires and settled civilizations in India. Metal ores like iron and copper, gold and silver, coal and diamonds, invaluable timber, most medicinal herbs and animal products, wax, lac, honey, and animals themselves, elephants, the mainstay of imperial armies, all came from the forests. In addition, the continuation of life depended heavily on forests that help recharge many of India's rivers and is becoming clearer now. Crucial to the availability of and quality of our air and water, forests covered the major part of our country till the 19th century, and the Adivasis had a deep knowledge of access to as well as control over most of these vast tracts at least till the middle of the 19th century. This meant that they were not ruled by large states and empires. Instead, often empires heavily dependent on Adivasis for the crucial access to forest resources. This is radically contrary to our image of Adivasis today as somewhat marginal and powerless communities. In the pre-colonial world, they were traditionally ranged hunter-gatherers and nomads and lived by shifting agriculture and also cultivating in one place. Although these remain for the past 200 years, Adivasis have been increasingly forced through economic changes, forest policies and political force applied by the state and private industry to migrate to lives as workers in plantations, at construction sites, in industries and as domestic workers. For the first time in history, they do not control or have much direct access to the forest territories. From the 1830 onwards, Adivasis from Jharkhand and adjoining areas moved in very large numbers to various plantations in India and the world. Mauritius, the Caribbean and even Australia. India's tea industry became possible with their labor in Assam. टुडे देर आर 70 लाख आदिवासीज इन आसाम अलोन. द स्टोरी ऑफ दिस माइग्रेशन इज फुल ऑफ एक्सट्रीम हार्डशिप, टॉर्चर, हार्ट ब्रेक एंड डेथ. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इन द 19th century अलोन 5 लाख आदिवासीज हैड perished in these migrations. The song below captures the hopes of the migrants and the reality they faced in Assam. ये दोस्तों कुछ क्वेश्चन है, ये आप लोग टीचर के साथ मिलकर डिस्कस कर लें जो इंपॉर्टेंट है. तो ये सॉन्ग है दोस्तों, आप लोग ये आसाम ये देख लें आप लोग, ठीक है, पढ़ लीजिएगा सॉन्ग. सॉन्ग आपके लिए मतलब एग्जाम परस्पेक्टिव के लिए तो एग्जाम इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं है कि सॉन्ग लिखने दे देगा या फिर कुछ ऐसे कुछ. तो ये सब सॉन्ग आप टीचर से जरूर समझे दोस्तों. ये सब हो गया. चलिए, दिस इज अ फोटो ऑफ नियामगिरी हिल लोकेटेड इन कालाहंडी डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ उड़ीसा. दिस एरिया इज इनहैबिटेड बाय डोंगरिया कोंड्स एन आदिवासी कम्युनिटी. नियामगिरी इज द सेक्रेड माउंटेन ऑफ दिस कम्युनिटी. अ मेजर एल्यूमिनियम कंपनी इज प्लानिंग टू सेटअप अ माइन एंड रिफाइनरी हियर विच विल डिस्प्लेस दिस आदिवासी कम्युनिटी. They have strongly resisted this proposed development and have been joined by environmentalists as well. A case against the company is also pending in the Supreme Court. ये दिखा रखा दोस्तों नियामगिरी हिल का लोकेशन है, कौन से डिस्ट्रिक्ट में, कालाहंडी डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ उड़ीसा. Forest lands have been cleared for timber and to get land for agriculture and industry. Adivasis have also lived in areas that are rich in minerals and other natural resources. These are taken over for mining and other large industrial projects. Powerful forces have often colluded to take over tribal land. Much of the time, the land is taken away forcefully and procedures are not followed. देखिए दोस्तों, आप लोग को NCERT पढ़ने में इसलिए बोलता हूँ, देखिए एक वर्ड आया है colluded. जैसा कि दोस्तों मैं आपको पहले मैं बताना चाहूँगा कि मैंने NDA का एग्ज़ाम भी क्वालिफाई कर रखा है, तो उसके में क्या होता है ना कि आपको सिनोनिम एंटोनिम ये सब बताना पड़ता है. तो सिनोनिम, हमारे एक सिनोनिम में ऐसा भी आता था कोल्यूड. कोल्यूड का मतलब क्या होता है कि किसी के खिलाफ षड्यंत्र रच के, कंस्पायर जिसको बोलते हैं, षड्यंत्र रचना किसी के खिलाफ, ठीक है, या धोखे से कुछ चीज़ टेक ओवर कर लेना. तो ये देखिए आपके यहाँ पे दिया है ना, NCERT पढ़ना इसलिए ज़रूरी है दोस्तों क्योंकि NCERT में ना बहुत ही सिंपल तरीके से और बहुत ही अच्छे अच्छे वर्ड्स रहते हैं जो कि आपको काम आते हैं कम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम्स में. चलो दोस्तों, ये छोटी सी इन्फॉर्मेशन थी, आशा करता हूँ आपको पसंद आएगी. तो चलिए कंटिन्यू करते हैं. अकॉर्डिंग टू ऑफिशियल फिगर्स, मोर देन 50% ऑफ पर्सन्स डिस्प्लेस्ड ड्यू टू माइंस एंड माइनिंग प्रोजेक्ट्स आर ट्राइबल्स. अनदर रीसेंट सर्वे रिपोर्ट बाय ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस वर्किंग अमंग आदिवासीज शोज दैट 79% ऑफ द पर्सन्स displaced from the states of Andhra Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Odisha and Jharkhand are tribals. Huge tracts of their lands have also gone under the waters of hundreds of dams that have been built in independent India. In the northeast, their lands remain highly militarized. India has 101 national parks covering 40,564 square kilometers and 543 wildlife sanctuaries covering 119,776 square kilometer. These are areas where tribals originally lived but were evicted from. When they continue to stay in these forests, they are termed encroachers. Losing their land and access to the forest means that tribals lose their main sources of livelihood and food. Having gradually lost access to their traditional homelands, many Adivasis have migrated to cities in search of work where they are employed for very low wages in local industries or at building or construction sites. They thus get caught in a cycle of poverty and deprivation. 45% of tribal groups in rural areas and 35% in urban areas live below the poverty line. This leads to deprivation in other areas. Many tribal children are malnourished. Literacy rates among tribals are also very low. Adivasis use around 10,000 plant species. Approximately 8,000 species are used for medicinal purposes. 325 are used as pesticides. 425 as gums, resins and dyes. 550 as fibers. 3,500 are edible. This entire knowledge system gets wiped out when Adivasis lose their rights over forest lands. ये सब कुछ क्वेश्चन है दोस्तों, आपका ओपिनियन मांगा जा रहा है यहाँ पे, आप लोग ये सब टीचर के साथ डिस्कस कर लिए कौन सा क्वेश्चन इंपॉर्टेंट है कौन सा क्वेश्चन नहीं इंपॉर्टेंट. ठीक है दोस्तों, जो इंपॉर्टेंट है उनको उनके आंसर्स याद कर लिया करें. When Adivasis are displaced from their lands, they lose much more than a source of income. They lose their traditions and customs, a way of living and being. They took our farming land. They left some houses. They took the cremation ground, temple, well and pond. How will we survive? Says Govinda Maran, who was displaced due to a refinery project in Odisha. As you have read, there exists an interconnectedness between the economic and social dimensions of tribal life. Destruction in one sphere naturally impacts the other. Often this process of dispossession and displacement can be painful and violent. Minorities and marginalization. In Unit 1, you read that the Constitution provides safeguards to religious and linguistic minorities as part of our fundamental rights. Why do you think these minority groups have been provided these safeguards? The term minority is most commonly used to refer communities that are numerically small in relation to the rest of the population. However, it is a concept that goes well beyond numbers. It encompasses issues of power, access to resources, and has social and cultural dimensions. As you read in Unit 1, the Indian Constitution recognized that the culture of the majority influences the way in which society and government might express themselves. In such cases, size can be a disadvantage and lead to the marginalization of the relatively smaller communities. Thus, safeguards are needed to protect minority communities against the possibility of being culturally dominated by the majority. They also protect them against any discrimination and disadvantage that they may face. Given certain conditions, communities that are smaller in number relative to the rest of the society may feel insecure about their lives, assets, and well-being. This sense of insecurity may get accentuated if the relations between the minority and मेजॉरिटी कम्युनिटीज आर फ्रॉड. देखिए दोस्तों, मैं बता रहा हूँ, अगर आपने एनसीईआरटी बढ़िया से पढ़ लिया ना दोस्तों, आपको कम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम्स में सिनोनिम और एंटोनिम की दिक्कत तो बहुत कम आएगी दोस्त. ये देखो, एक्सेंचुएटेड जो है ना, एक्सेंचुएटेड मतलब किसी पे जोर देना या किसी चीज़ को हाईलाइट करना, ठीक है, ये होता है. अब समझ रहे हैं दोस्तों, ये आपको याद करने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी जब आप कम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम्स की तैयारी करेंगे, आपको तो पहले से याद रहेगा ना दोस्त. तो याद रखना भाई, एनसीईआरटी 4-5 बार पढ़ लोगे, मैं सच बता रहा हूँ, बहुत सारे वर्ड्स ऐसे आ जाएंगे ना जो कि आपको कम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम से इंपॉर्टेंट मिलेंगे. तो आपको हर एनसीईआरटी आपको समझ में आ गई तो आपको सब समझ में आ जाएगा दोस्त, याद रखना. आपने ये कहावत भी सुनी होगी, जिसने एनसीईआरटी पढ़ लेता है वो आराम से कोई भी कम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम्स पास कर सकता है, ठीक है. तो ये बात इस बात में उतनी ही सच्चाई है दोस्तों, ठीक है. चलिए, द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन प्रोवाइड्स दीज सेफगार्ड्स बिकॉज इट इज़ कमिटेड टू प्रोटेक्टिंग इंडियाज़ कल्चरल डाइवर्सिटी एंड प्रोमोटिंग इक्वलिटी एज वेल एज जस्टिस. As you have already read in chapter 5, the judiciary plays a crucial role in upholding the law and enforcing fundamental rights. Every citizen of India can approach the courts if they believe that their fundamental rights have been violated. Now let us understand marginalization in the context of the Muslim community. तो ये देखिए, why do we need safeguards for minority? कुछ questions होते हैं जो कि अच्छे होते हैं दोस्तों, आप लोग इनको teacher के साथ discuss जरूर करा करें इनके answers. Muslims and marginalization. According to 2011 census, Muslims are 14.2% of India's population and are considered to be a marginalized community in India today because in comparison to other communities, they have over the years been deprived of the benefits of socio-economic development. The data in the three tables below derived from different sources indicate the situation of the Muslim community with regard to basic amenities, literacy and public employment. Read the tables below. What do you think these tables tell us about the socio-economic status of the Muslim community? ये देखो दोस्तों, आप लोग देख सकते हैं यहाँ पे कुछ लिखी हुई है, पक्का है, हाउस, इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, टैप वाटर कितने परसेंट के पास था, कितने परसेंट के पास नहीं है, ठीक है दोस्तों. तो आप लोग देखिए, इसको कंपेयर कीजिए, ये आपका काम है दोस्त, ठीक है. ये सब दोस्त देख सकते हैं दोस्तों, ठीक है. What do these figures convey? तो ये ऐसे आपको आंसर करना है. Recognizing that Muslims in India were lagging behind in terms of वेरियस डेवलपमेंट इंडिकेटर्स द गवर्नमेंट सेटअप अ हाई लेवल कमिटी गवर्नमेंट द गवर्नमेंट सेटअप अ हाई लेवल कमिटी इन 2005 चेयर्ड बाय सोशल जस्टिस रजिंदर साचर द कमिटी चेयर्ड बाय जस्टिस रजिंदर साचर द कमिटी एग्जामिन्ड द सोशल इकोनॉमिक एंड एजुकेशनल स्टेटस ऑफ द मुस्लिम कम्युनिटी इन इंडिया द रिपोर्ट डिस्कसेस इन डिटेल द मार्जिनलाइजेशन ऑफ दिस कमिटी इट सजेस्ट दैट ऑन अ रेंज ऑफ सोशल इकोनॉमिक एंड एजुकेशनल इंडिकेटर्स द सिचुएशन ऑफ द मुस्लिम कम्युनिटी इज कंपेरेबल टू दैट ऑफ अदर मार्जिनलाइज कम्युनिटीज लाइक शेड्यूल्ड कास्ट एंड शेड्यूल्ड ट्राइब्स फॉर एग्जाम्पल अकॉर्डिंग टू द रिपोर्ट द एवरेज ईयर्स ऑफ schooling for muslim children between the ages of 7 to 16 is much lower than that of other socio religious communities to aise aap log dekh sakte hain dosto page 56 mein iska reference hai theek hai ye sab question aap teacher ke sath milke discuss kar sakte hain agar important hai to economic and social marginalization experienced by muslims has other dimensions as well like other minorities Muslim customs and practices are sometimes quite distinct from what is seen as the mainstream. Some, not all, Muslims may wear a burqa or sport a long beard, wear a fez, and these become ways to identify all Muslims. Because of this, they tend to be identified differently, and some people think they are not like the rest of us. Often this becomes an excuse to treat them unfairly and discriminate against them. Do you remember reading in your class 7 book about how the Ansaris were finding it difficult to rent a house? This social marginalization of Muslims in some instances has led to them migrating from places where they have lived, often leading to the ghettoization of the community. Sometimes this prejudice leads to hatred and violence. Muslim women are important part of the women's movement in India. तो ये क्या है? Stop attack on Muslim women's rights. Stop attack on Muslim women's rights. अच्छा ये सब देख सकते हैं दोस्तों यहाँ पे दिखा रखा है. Ghettoization ये जो blue blue color में दिखा रहता है ना दोस्तों इसके ये पीछे आपका summary में दिया उसमें glossary में दिया रहता है वहाँ पे पढ़ूँगा इसके बारे में ठीक है. I live in a Muslim-dominated area. Some days back during Ramzan, there was some disturbance that started taking a communal outlook. My brother and I had gone for an iftar party in the neighborhood and were dressed in traditional clothes, that is, sherwani and salwar kameez respectively. On returning home, my brother and I were asked to change our clothes to jeans and t-shirt. Now, when everything is fine, I wonder what was the reason that we were asked to change our clothes and why I didn't find it odd. Were our clothes giving away our identity? And is that identity linked to all kinds of fears and discrimination? Aine A. Faruqi. ये दोस्तों दिखा लिखा गया है कुछ आप इसके बारे में देख लें और ये दबे तो ये दोस्तों कुछ क्वेश्चंस हैं इसे आप लोग देख सकते हैं ठीक है अगर इम्पॉर्टेंट है तो आप याद भी कर सकते हैं इसके बारे में हालांकि ये सब उतना इम्पॉर्टेंट ज़्यादा है नहीं ठीक है एक बात बता दूं दोस्तों आपको पॉलिटिकल साइंस की किताब में ना ये जो साइड में क्वेश्चंस होते हैं ना वो ज़्यादातर आपके बारे में आपके ओपिनियन के बारे में जानना चाहते हैं और एग्ज़ाम में क्वेश्चंस आपके ओपिनियन के बारे में नहीं आते एग्ज़ाम में क्वेश्चन रॉक सॉलिड आते हैं जो कि होते हैं मैं CBSE की बात कर मैं खासकर तो KV के सिस्टम्स की बात कर रहा हूँ और बाकी स्कूल में भी ओपिनियन के बारे में थोड़ी पूछते होंगे यार क्योंकि ओपिनियन में तो कोई कॉन्क्रीट आंसर होगा ही नहीं फिर सबके ओपिनियन अलग अलग हो जाएंगे तो जनरली क्या होता है एग्ज़ाम्स में स्कूल के कि वो लोग पूछते हैं नॉर्मल क्वेश्चन जो कि रॉक सॉलिड आंसर हो जिसके मतलब सही एक्यूरेट आंसर हो ठीक है तो इन द अबव सेक्शन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर वी सॉ हाउ इन द केस ऑफ द मुस्लिम कम्युनिटी देयर इज़ अ लिंक बिटवीन इकोनॉमिक एंड सोशल मार्जिनलाइजेशन Earlier in this chapter, you read about the situation of Adivasis. In your class 7 book, you read about the unequal status of women in India. The experiences of all these groups point to the fact that marginalization is a complex phenomenon requiring a variety of strategies, measures and safeguards to redress this situation. All of us have a stake in protecting the rights defined in the constitution and the laws एंड पॉलिसीज फ्रेम्ड टू रियलाइज दीज राइट्स. विदाउट दीज वी विल नेवर बी एबल टू प्रोटेक्ट द डाइवर्सिटी दैट मेक्स आवर कंट्री यूनिक नॉर रियलाइज द स्टेट्स कमिटमेंट टू प्रोटेक्ट टू प्रमोट इक्वालिटी फॉर ऑल. कंक्लूजन. In this chapter, we have tried to understand what it means to be a marginalized community. We have tried to look at this through the experiences of different marginalized communities. There are different reasons for each of these communities being marginalized. Each experiences marginalization in different ways. We have also seen that marginalization is linked to experiencing disadvantage, prejudice, and powerlessness. In India, there are several more marginalized communities like Dalits, of whom you will read more in the next chapter. Marginalization results in having a low status and not having equal access to education and other resources. Yet the lives of marginalized people can and do change. Thus, no one is marginalized all the time in exactly the same way. If we go back to the two examples of marginalization we have discussed, we will see that each of these groups has a long history of struggle and resistance. Marginalized communities want to maintain their cultural distinctiveness while having access to rights, development and other opportunities. In the next chapter, we will read about how different groups have confronted marginalization. The Sachar Committee report also debunked other prevalent myths about Muslims. It is commonly believed that the Muslims prefer to send their children to madrasas. The figures show that only 4% of Muslim children in India are in madrasas, whereas 66% attend government schools and 30% private schools. ये आप लोग को दिखा रखा है दोस्तों, ठीक है. वो कहाँ है? अच्छा ना, अच्छा हाँ. तो चलिए, ये चैप्टर हो गया पूरा और अब हम लोग ग्लॉसरी पढ़ते हैं, देखते हैं दोस्तों. ग्लॉसरी बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट होती है. हायरार्की, अ ग्रेडेड सिस्टम और अरेंजमेंट ऑफ पर्सन्स और थिंग्स. यूजुअली पर्सन्स एट द बॉटम ऑफ द हायरार्की आर दोज हु हैव द लीस्ट पावर. द कास्ट सिस्टम इज अ हायरार्कियल सिस्टम एंड दलित्स आर कंसिडर्ड टू बी एट द लोएस्ट एंड. घिट्टोइजेशन, अ घिट्टो इज एन एरिया और लोकेलिटी दैट इज पॉपुलेटेड लार्जली बाय मेंबर्स ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर कम्युनिटी. घिट्टोइजेशन रेफर्स टू द प्रोसेस दैट लीड्स to such a situation. This may occur due to various social, cultural and economic reasons. Fear or hostility may also compel a community to group together as they feel more secure living amongst their own. Often a ghettoized community has few options of moving out, which may lead to them becoming alienated from the rest of the society mainstream. Literally, this refers to the main current of a river or system. In this chapter, it is used to refer to a cultural context in which the customs and practices that are followed are those of the dominant community. In connection with this, mainstream is also used to refer to those people or communities that are considered to be at the center of a society that is often the powerful or dominant group. Displaced, in the context of this chapter, this refers to the people who are forced or compelled to move from their homes or for big development projects including dams, mining, etc. Militarized, an area where the presence of the armed forces is considerable. Malnourished, a person who does not get adequate nutrition or food. इसी तरह दोस्तों हमारा ये चैप्टर हो जाता है पूरा. और आप लोगों का बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया कि आप लोग अंत तक बने रहे. आप लोगों का बहुत 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 बधाइयाँ कि आप लोग अंत तक बने रहे. और अब ये चैप्टर एक बार आप लोग इनडायरेक्टली रीड कर चुके हैं दोस्तों. इनडायरेक्टली इसलिए बोल रहा हूँ क्योंकि रीड तो मैंने किया, लेकिन आपने सुन के, आपने कम से कम सुना तो और सुन लिया तो कम से कम आपका सुनने से बहुत चीज़ें ज़्यादा याद रहती है दोस्तों. अगर आप किसी चीज़ को सिर्फ देखेंगे तो आपको वो उतनी याद नहीं रहेगी, लेकिन अगर आप कोई चीज़ सुने हुए रहेंगे तो आपको चीज़ें याद रहती है. और अगर आप सुनते हुए देखते रहेंगे तब तो आपको बहुत ज़्यादा चांस है कि वो चीज़ बहुत अच्छे से आपको याद रह सकती है दोस्तों, ठीक है. तो बस इतने के साथ ही मैं अपने शब्दों को विराम देना चाहूँगा अभी और इस वीडियो के लिए इतना ही. आप लोग एकदम पढ़ाई ऐसे ही करते रहें, 5-6 बार वीडियोस को देखें स्पीड बढ़ा के ताकि आपका टाइम कम कंज्यूम हो. हालांकि हमने 35 मिनट के पहले ये चैप्टर कंप्लीट कर लिया है दोस्तों. और मिलते हैं आपसे नेक्स्ट वीडियो में. थैंक यू एंड हैव अ नाइस डे. मेरे बेस्ट विशेज हमेशा आपके साथ रहते हैं. वीडियो को लाइक, शेयर और सब्सक्राइब जरूर करें अगर ये वीडियो आपको मदद कर रही है दोस्तों, ठीक है.